Okay, thank you so much for coming. Thank you to everybody who is watching online. This is Moving the Map. I am Julie Johnson, co-editor of The Dancer Citizen, which is an online scholarly, open access journal exploring the work of socially engaged dance artists. And we are presenting Dancer Citizen Live 2018 Moving the Map, which features the work of artists in five different cities and some of the themes that have come up in the journal articles. So here at the Atlanta site, we're doing Moving Our Stories, Erasure, Resistance, and Survival, with a story around a dance collective featuring Kayla Bird, Charming Minifield. And we have live music by Corey Dante. And before I go any further to what we've been working on, I just want to take a moment and acknowledge that we are situated here in Atlanta, which is the traditional and ancestral land of the Chickasaw and Muskogee people. And since our core themes are about erasure and amplification, I just wanted to call that into the space today. We've been thinking about erasure and amplification, particularly the ways in which communities, cultures, practices, and spaces are at risk of erasure, and how embodied memory and movement can serve as a way to address that erasure, how amplification can be a remedy for erasure. And so what you're going to see today is this interactive exhibit that focuses on this year-long process of the work that we've been doing around these themes. So over here we have photographs by Renata Irving featuring the members of the Story Ground Dance Collective. We have Sienna-type fabric art by Drew Charter, 8th grade dance student. Thanks to Sandra, we have this work. And it connects to amplification and erasure with the use of positive and negative space and light. And so when we're talking about it, we're like, yes, we need that in space. I'm so grateful that they shared that with us. We have been in a year-long process with Charlene Minifield and her Remembering as Resistance Visually Mapping the Race Project. We have her projection installation. If you go behind, it's like experiencing Ring Shout space from the inside out. And so there's something on the wall to explain that a little bit further. But we've kind of been drawing from the traditions and rituals of the Ring Shout, while also creating kind of the contemporary aesthetic around these ideas of erasure and amplification. The Ring Shout is a traditional spiritual practice, African American practice created on plantations. We've been drawing from that and honoring the communities who still preserve and continue these practices to this day. Over here we have a scent station. This is such a multi-sensory experience. What about smells? So we curated these smells that kind of amplify our memories. So we invite you to go over and check out some of these different smell memories. And then right next to it, we have our word cloud. So we ask, when do you feel erased? When do you feel amplified? Can you share some of these thoughts, write them on a post-it note, stick it on the wall to create a word cloud if you're willing. We would love to have that as part of this kind of collective layer of meaning around this work. And we might pull some of your words, some of your thoughts into the movement later on in the performance. So, and then papers on the floor. Underneath each one is a little prompt. And you just follow the instruction if you're willing, or you can just kind of watch and see what happens. But it's meant to create this spontaneous collective movement to amplify space, amplify work presence in space. So basically, we're starting with this interactive exhibit. We're inviting you to kind of get up, go explore the space, read what's on the wall, try out things, share your words and thoughts. And then when you hear, Okay, Jello, start to play, that is your cue to again take your seats or stand around the outside because the movement is going to begin with Joy Brown Dance Collective. And then we're going to invite them back into the movement later on. Before that, I've got to say this. During, when you're checking out the space, I would love for you to come this way.
Over here is Mr. Will Fegans. Pick up this microphone and share some thoughts about your experience with this space. Or maybe share your thoughts about what amplification and erasure means to you. Right? So that the folks who are watching online can get a deeper sense of what's happening in this space. Okay, so you all are really a part of this work. Okay, so there's that, there's the movement, our collective movement, using some of your words, and then we'll have a Q&A at the end. Does that all make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So there are bathrooms here and here, and thank you. See, I'm holding this because if I forget, then I'm in trouble. Thank you. Do alternate routes for the artistic assistance. Funds from the Nathan Cummings Foundation, Ford Foundation, Service Foundation, and Andrew W. Mellon Foundation, and to the Dancer Citizen for the generous support. Thank you to TA for facilitating the use of the space. Thank you to all the volunteers and the videographers and our TV, Brooks and David and everybody for helping make this happen. And Mia, thank you to all the collaborators and dancers and Charmaine and everybody, and thank you to the audience for coming and being a part of this. So I think that's everything. Dancers, at your discretion, try out the space. Interact. And then we'll know who the movement started when you hear the
and
love the seatbelt.
My name is Charmaine Minifield. I'm a visual artist. I am one of the collaborators on this project. It's so cool to see everyone in this space experiencing the ring show. I'm so grateful to be a part. And we are lifting up the voices of those that weren't remembered, and now we're remembering them. Ashe.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Celebrating each other's experiences and differences, challenges. So thank you all for being in this with us together. We still have time. The live stream's gonna end. Thank you for everybody on the live stream coming. It's you.
For the circle, the counterclockwise circle where we were we looked like we were protecting each other's space as we danced inside of that. For me, kind of like Mika said, sometimes the movement would come first. Like it wasn't like, I think I'm going to do this movement right now because I want to express such and so. Because it was that particular section is very improvisational. Just the feeling of being in one particular second of your body, that is such a liberating feeling. And then once I was in that process of liberating, I was like, oh, I was mad about something the other day. That's what I'm gonna stay in this movement because this will allow me to express that even in just these few seconds. So not so pre-planned in terms of the intent of it, but just what comes out, allowing ourselves to amplify that in that space and feel safe in that space, and then each other, key sister, and then having each other guard that space while you're protected there.
I just want to make an announcement about Charmaine just left. She's walking out the door. She's on her way to the closing exhibit of Black Angels. That's her exhibit at the Auburn Avenue Research Library. So once you're done here, go ahead on over there and check out her amazing work, you know, that's amplifying, Black women's bodies and ancestors and I'm losing my words, but it's a really beautiful exhibit.
It's super beautiful, and we are blessed to be featured in that exhibit as well. So she took some of these types of photographs and painted them. So images of us are inside of her exhibit, in addition to some of the images that you see here
If you want to watch any of the other works that was happening today, it's Pride Moving the Map in the other cities. I meant to mention this before. Go to dancercitizen.org, and you'll see it there. It's archived. I think it'll be over at about 4 o'clock today, but you can go back anytime to take a look. Any other?
Yes. It's a message that we deal with, and it's a question.
How long have you been?
having some classes last summer, some African diasporic Muslim aesthetic classes. That's the best one. I don't know what you call them. They were so much fun. So we were like taking our class, and different ones, different people in the community were taking class too. And then we were like, let's keep dancing. Okay, let's keep dancing. When y'all want to get together? Cool, let's get together that day. So it's been about a year, Zaya, and we would get together about once a week, and we would dance for about a couple of hours. And you came to one of our sessions one time.
Yes, you did.
And you had some really wonderful input too. So I was gonna say, and I'm gonna get to you. So Baba, you were asking about how choreographed it was. So our, we had a map to it. Like, we knew that this particular section is solos, this particular section will face this way, this section you face each other, this section is a frenzy, this section is a this, that, and the other. And then there were sections inside of that that were improvisational and chunks of it that were choreographed. And that choreography was based on our collective improvisation inside of rehearsal.
You already knew each other and know each other going into your time together this past year. But I'm wondering about how trust goes into this process for each of you or a couple of you to respond about trusting each other with that vulnerability in rehearsals, but also in this space together, especially during the times of three holding the space while the other person was in the center dancing, and just what that looked like for that trust.
I think one of the things that helped build that was not having an agenda every time we met, and just allowing whatever we needed in the moment to happen, whether it was I just have to talk about what happened today, my day today, and like sitting on the ground and just talking about stuff, or I can't say anything today, I just have to move, or I'm just gonna like watch y'all and hold the space. But then I don't think anybody ever did that, girl. Like, eventually, so, you know, having that really open flow allowed us to be open. I just feel like it just
be
happened.
And organic, and that in those moments, because we were able to be open, because we were able to be present right there in that second, I think that allowed for us to trust. Because we didn't hold anything back.
I held something back. So the beginning, like, it was just like, oh, these some girls I want to dance with, that's cool, whatever. But like, we were talking about this a couple of days ago, how this space has helped me in my outside life. So it's like, this is more of like a healing space and a space where you can, well, for me, I can be more vulnerable and like more open and kind of let people in and kind of see me, you know? So for me in the beginning, it was like, I'm dancing, I'm like, well, that's stupid, I don't want to do it. Or, hey, I have an idea. Hey, what do you think? And I'm like, that's ugly. Like, I had my own self-doubt and trusting myself. So throughout this whole year, just kind of being with them, talking to them, and having a voice, and them literally amplifying me throughout the process, it's been really healing. And I was able to really open up more. Because you think, oh yeah, she's pretty open. Not for real, for real. So it was just really nice to heal in this space and to see what trust is, and then allow myself to trust them. It was an experience for me. It was a process for me. So even like letting people, you know, I kept saying, I feel like people are in our house. Because it's like we've held this space for so long with each other, and I was like, I don't want to bring people in. So just for me to see self-reflection, I'm like, wow. I'm ready to bring people in. I'm ready to open up. And really, this space is really going to take me into that world. I'm saying that world, you know, when you get out of here, and really be more vulnerable with myself, be vulnerable with other people, be able to trust myself. I realize that I don't trust people because I don't trust myself. Mm. So I'm like, oh, okay, dance, you know what I'm saying? So I've learned a lot about myself and trust, personal trust, opening my circle of trust. So that was my experience.
I just want to say I appreciate Ofori when he started working with us, as he was so mindful about entering this space. And I think it was pretty clear what we kind of had created. And I remember one of the questions you asked was like, you know, the cello can be, it can have like a male energy, it can have a female energy, like what kind of energy are you wanting? And even just that question, was, I just thought it was so considerate. Yeah. You know, that was the mindfulness in which he entered the space, and it just worked out. So uh-huh. We appreciate that very much. And the cello itself is music, like, it's so open to me. If I'm not, like, the way I feel it is, it's just so open, and there's space within the music to move around in,
I want to speak to trust real quick and then get Mama Melika's question. So I think that one of the things that helped to create a space of trust for us is that we don't really correct each other too much. Like, it's not so much about your technique and whether your foot is pointed or how high your leg is or how many turns you got. It's really just how that movement is able to come out through your body. Like, we don't all have the same capabilities. I mean, we're able to complement each other very well. But I remember something that I did, something Julie was like, oh, my back doesn't do that. You know, like, people's knees are very, very pliable. They work really well. So, and you know, sometimes like, okay, well, my knees don't really do that. So the judgment, just not having the judgment there, like having a really judgment-free zone, is really good, and then having a space where you can compliment each other so often. Like, I like that. You like, really? You like that? Yes, I like that. And then to be able to tell each other why. So those compliments still feels good.
Wow. Because every time I had one thing that I wanted to say and something else. So firstly, I'm so proud of the four of you. Journey that you all have gone on to get to this place. I'm just really, really, y'all, this is a big deal for me, right? This was just really, really, really cool. Space was what you did, seeing out there and hearing Mama City, you just shows what you all, how you all allowed yourselves to be vessels. Creating a space for each other, creating a space for us. So I just want to, there was maybe a banana in my ass. So thank you for giving each other a space to give us a space to experience that and then come out and share it the same way. And then, did you score this or were you improvising right along with it? Was the music was just
wonderful? Thank you. So the process that they use to create the choreography is the same process that I use to create music. So usually what happens is I take a long time to set up. So they start moving, and you know, by the time I'm set up and ready to go, I just jump into something. It's usually not something I've written. It's usually just a bass line or an interior part, and they start moving to it. And then there's this kind of give and take. So like, oh, like, I like that, do that again. So I play that part again, I try and add to it, and then sometimes I forget, I'm like, oh, I don't remember. Frequently, we would have it videotaped. So that was helpful. So we would improvise movement, we'd improvise sound to the movement, or the movement will sometimes come from the sound, and then we look at it and say, oh, we like that. But in all honesty, I don't think we really nailed down four pieces of music until the last verse. So some of the movement I think had already been choreographed, and I've been playing to some of it probably over the last few months, but I think we just decided, oh, I like that. Can you make sure that you can do that again? And so that's what we do. And I would say 60% of all the songs are written, and then the remaining 40% is responsive and improvised and hoping to kind of catch movements. They're such graceful dancers that I'm usually like two phrases behind, like, oh, put them on that, right? And then I find the rhythm, and then they've done it twice, and then they're on to the next one. So it's been a really exciting improvisational process for me, but more important, a process that required that I was present and really paying attention.
So, last question, and then we'll wrap up.
Yes. Not more necessarily a question, but just a couple of comments. I'm a super fan of OK Chavo, so that's how I found out about you guys. But it's just how the universe brings you to where you're supposed to be. And I just felt a lot of love and light here, so thank you.
So we invite you to continue to explore this space and check out the Inside Out, the sound space behind there. Add your thoughts to our word cloud. While that's happening, we're going to be breaking down the space because we can't stay in here past today. So just know that's happening around you. There's still refreshments out in the other studio. Please enjoy. I will not be taking any food home, so just please share all those, enjoy all those snacks. Watch the rest of the live stream, dancercitizen.org. Everything will be archived there. And yeah, if you have any other questions about anything, reach out. Yes.
I have a quick comment.
Yes.
Yes. So 75% of us are doing this are also members of EY and Monson.
Yes.
We're getting ready to come in here and start rehearsing in a little while. But I just want to tell you what we're rehearsing for. So we're rehearsing for our 25th year anniversary concert.
July 14th.
Yes, July 14th. We're going to be performing at the Ray Charles Performing Arts Center over on Morehouse's campus. And we'll have a gala and award ceremony before that, and a performance in the evening at 8 o'clock. And we just want to invite you all out to see the All Sister Dance Percussion and Vocal Ensemble. And to see just some of the pulse of kind of where some of us are dancing from. And Julie is so freaking awesome because as like incredibly creative, intellectually minded, and like grown and mature and expressive and like artistically evolved as she is, you know, she comes and takes EY and lots of classes, and she's like, I love dancing with you all, and it just felt so organic and clean and smooth just to work with you this whole year. So I just wanted to just send you some ashe.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.